Hi, everyone. Welcome to the show. I'm Tiffany.
And I'm Sam.
And Sam, I think you might be addicted to your smartphone a little bit too much.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
No denying it. Yes. How does it affect you sometimes? Like, do you ever, like, go crazy if you don't have your phone with you? Or
yeah, all the time.
If you don't run out of battery, or like if your battery's only 50%.
I found that I spend too much time using my smartphone, so I don't have time to do other things. Like now I don't have time to play video games, I don't have to go out, or I don't have time to sleep.
Whoa.
Because I spend too much time watching my phone or playing my phone, and it's bad.
I know, a little bit. To the point where you don't have enough free time. I think I need an intervention for you. I need to cleanse you from your smartphone addiction. I'm going to lock you away in the forest, away from civilization for a few days until...
until I get back to normal.
So I think nowadays, although smartphones and all this technology is super convenient, it really does have an it really does affect us sometimes, because even for me, like, I don't use my phone as much, but when I do, I use it as a way to just relax and to talk to people. And then sometimes I accidentally talk too long with people that, you know, it's already past the time I want to go to bed, for example.
Yeah.
And then you wake up the next day tired and stuff. So, technology is great, but then also at the same time, it can affect us as well.
Mm-hmm.
So, I guess we just have to try to find a balance then. All right. So,
we can never.
I know. Unless, I don't know, unless something, a new kind of thing.
Yeah, a different technology.
Yeah, but I think it's going to be very difficult. We are way too connected with the internet now. People want to use the internet all the time, so it's very difficult to get yourself out. Unless you live in a place where there's no internet at all. You live in the countryside, or you live in a forest by yourself. Sam is like, oh no. I don't ever want that to happen to me. All right. So today we have a writing article. Mm-hmm. And what we're going to do is we have a picture, or like three pictures, and then we have to write a story for the fourth one. So it's kind of like a comic book. So let's take a look at our writing article for today. All right, so let's take a look at what our writing task for today is.
Okay, 今天呢，我们要来看连环图片写作了。请仔细呢观察下方三幅连环图片的内容，并想象呢第四幅图片可能的发展，写出篇呢120字以上的文章。文章呢需涵盖连环图片的内容，并且呢要有完整的结局。
Mm-hmm. So here we have three pictures, and on the bottom right, we see one of them is a question mark. So that means that we can write a story and think about what might happen next, or what happened next in the story. Now, we must write at least 120 words, and of course, every story needs a beginning and an end. So we cannot just all of a sudden talk about something in the middle and then just leave it there. We have to have a beginning and an end, beginning, middle, and the end.
Okay, 今天呢，我们要来做的就是这个看图写作了。那这个图呢是一个连环图，所以呢我们要仔细观察图片里面发生了什么事情，并要讲一个完整的故事。注意到是一个完整的故事哦，它必须呢要开头，要有发展，要有结尾。那呢如果情节需要呢，建议你呢是可以把图片里面的人物命名哦，这样在写作的时候比较不会一直 he 啊怎样 she 啊怎样，这样到最后让阅读者呢都不知道到底谁是谁了。当然呢如果你要使用第一人称讲自己的故事等等，这些呢都是可以天马行空，你可以创意来发挥的。那呢另外呢，既然这个是一个故事哦，既然是故事，表示它是发生在过去，所以呢我们通常呢会使用过去时代的动词，例如说呢过去简单式、过去完成式呢来这个图片写作使用。
And again, just remember, if you are using past tense, stay in the past tense and don't change around tenses, because it also can be very confusing when we talk about the setting of the story when you're trying to explain the story as well. So, like I mentioned, stories always will have a beginning, middle, and end. These kind of stories are called narratives, and that means that it often includes people, their events, their things that are happening in the story. So, actually, the more details you give, the better the story will be, the more complete the story will be.
嗯哼，没有错，既然呢是要说故事，它当然呢就是需要起承转合。那这次的提示当中呢并没有要求要分段，但是呢建议还是可以分两到三段。那另外呢，对于图片里面的细节描述的越多呢，就能让读者呢越能够容易的来进入这个情境里面。
Mm-hmm. So, when we want to write a story, we can think about a storyline like a mountain or when you're about to climb a mountain. So, in the beginning, you have the beginning, which is the opening. So, this is like where we learn about who or what the story is about. Then we have something called the rising action. And this is the part where you kind of walk up the mountain and we learn a little bit more about what the problem of the story is. Next, we have the climax, which is if you're climbing the mountain, it's the very, very top of the mountain, you reach the peak. And the climax is where we face the problem. We find out, uh-oh, here's a conflict, here's a problem. We need to face it, or the characters have to face it. And then as you climb down the mountain, we have the resolution. And this is how we, or how the people in the story solve the problem, or how the problem gets solved.
OK, 故事的进展呢就像刚刚 Tiffany 说的好像爬山一样哦。OK, 你要注意到这个要有开头，要有高潮，要有这个解决问题，这个结局。那注意到呢，这次连环图片写作的重点呢就在于最后一张图要怎么给这个故事下结论了。这个结论呢你呢就可以好好发挥创意。那注意到了，提醒你哦，不管是多么的天马行空，如果是在考试之中呢，记得要留意自己会哪些句子，哪些单词，避免想了一个旷世巨作，但是呢很多描述，很多用法都没有办法好好表达，所以呢记得哦，用自己熟悉的，用自己会的方式好好的把故事说完，会是比较建议的做法咯。
Mm-hmm. All right, so here's a tip. We can actually separate the story into 3 to 4 parts if it's easier for you to do that. And you can think about it as like, okay,First part is the beginning, the middle, the second part is the middle. You can put it into 3 parts, beginning, middle, and the end. Now, the easiest thing to do is to quickly think about the setting of the story. So at least you have the beginning of the story settled down and you can kind of get the idea of what you want to talk about. So when you want to talk about the setting of the story, you can answer these WH questions. You can answer who, what, where, when, why,and how. And this is just a way for you to get things started and to kind of get your story rolling here.
OK, 看图写作的要诀呢就是要在开始的时候呢先问自己各种问题。OK, 你可以问说，比方说这个人是谁啊，是什么时间点发生的啊，他们在哪里。OK, 我们呢先来决定文章的时事人地物，先把场景设定好，后面写作呢比较不容易偏离主线哦，比较不会写到奇怪的地方去了。那同时呢也可以帮助你很快速的把这个情境建立起来，然后呢可以开始你的故事的发展。
Mm-hmm. All right, so we can look at the pictures together and maybe think about what the story is about. So in the first picture on the top left, I see this girl and her friend. They're having a good time and talking to each other. Maybe this could be her sister too, because I see it is quite late. And usually, your friends don't stay over that late unless they're sleeping over. So it could be her sister. In the next picture, I see that maybe her friend or sister has gone to sleep. So she starts to use her phone and maybe they're chatting on the phone.
Yeah.
And it looks like that. It looks like she's just
still
playing
chatting,
with her phone.
Yeah.
And that happens to us a lot. Like, and then when it's about bedtime, we're like, oh, let me use my phone for a bit. And you accidentally use your phone for an hour or something, right?
Yeah. It happens all the time.
It happens all the time. So that's why I think in the third picture, we can also take a look at the clock as well, because we can see that. Before, maybe it's in the evening, it's probably 2 a.m. And then now we see it's like 10 a.m.in the daytime,
yes.
And she has this shocked look on her face. So I'm thinking maybe she overslept.
Yeah.
So maybe she overslept. She probably forgot to set up her alarm. So she's like, oh no, I'm late for school or I'm late for work. And the next one, we have to think about a story for her. What do you think?
I think the third picture, since we can't see the window,So it's probably in the night, you know, 10 o'clock in the night. So I
she
think...
she slept that long?
Or she traveled back in time.
Oh, the twist to the story.
Yeah.
That's right. Remember, our stories don't have to always be like, you know, very direct. We can also put a twist in the story as well and to make
think
it even
more.
Think out of the box. Exactly. You can be very creative. Yeah. So, yes, we can see here that maybe she went back in time. Or maybe she was daydreaming.
Maybe.
You never know.
Inception.
Inception. A dream within a dream. okay, so, yeah, you can make it very, very interesting like that, where maybe she went back in time, or maybe she was just dreaming it all, or she was just dreaming it up and it never really happened, or something like that. So it's true, because we don't have too many details in this picture, so it's good. You can think about your own ideas. You can think about your own story. So Sam had a very, very good twist. I think that's cool. If you write about something, you go back in time, but how does she do that? We don't know.
Yeah, we'll find out.
We'll find out, but it's okay. If this is a very difficult story for you to write, don't worry. We actually have an outline for you and a sample story. So you can use this method if you are afraid you don't have, you know, you're not creative enough for that. But it's okay. You can do your best first. So don't think about things too much. Okay? So whenever we do a piece of writing, again, we can also create an outline. And this also just organizes your information better. So when you do write the story or when you do write the essay, it's more organized and you know exactly what you want to say in the first paragraph, second paragraph, third paragraph, and et cetera. Okay? So when you make an outline, we could take a look at our first topic sentence. Here in this example, it says, one night, Sherry invited her friend Brooke to hang out at her house.
OK, 所以呢在我们一开始就要先来这个 make an outline, 把这个大纲先写出来。那么第一段落的这个范例文章的第一段落呢，我们主题句就是这个有一天晚上呢 ,Sherry 呢邀请了他的朋友 Brooke 来他家一起玩。那在第一个句子呢，我们其实就已经把人物时间还有场景都已经设定好了，在他家在晚上。OK, 那注意到我们这边这个 one night 用法， one night 其实是这个写故事的时候很常用到，比方说 one day, one night, 某一天哦，某一天晚上等等，这个是在文章故事，尤其是故事写作里面呢，特别容易用到的一个用法。
Or if you want to write a fairy tale, you can say "Once upon a time."
Ah, yes.
That's always the opening title for a fairy tale. But here, maybe we can talk about something a little bit more realistic.
Yes, yes.
All right. So here in the first part of our outline, we're kind of again setting up the scene and the setting of the story. So here it says, they stayed up late chatting about Sherry's audition for a play.
Okay.
Okay, so Sherry has something important to do, and we can see that maybe Sherry is the girl with short hair.
Yeah.
Okay. And then it says, we can say Sherry was nervous, so she asked Brooke for some advice. So that's why they're talking to each other.
好，所以呢，我们看到他们为什么在这个 Sherry 家一起玩呢 ？OK， 他们呢就说他们那个熬夜到很晚。OK，stay up late 这个片语呢就是熬夜的意思。他们熬夜在干嘛呢？在聊天哦。因为 Sherry 呢，他有一个 audition 呢就是试镜的意思。那是什么样的试镜呢 ？For play 就是这个舞台剧哦。所以呢，他要去参加一个舞台剧的试镜，他很紧张哦。所以呢，他找这个 Brooke 来他家呢，他要怎么样 ？Ask Brooke for some advice。OK， 他问这个 Brooke 呢，他跟他寻求一点帮助，寻求一点建议。
But isn't it quite late for her friend to stay over at night? How old are they? Oh, it's okay. We can set up the age ourselves.
Yeah, maybe they're actresses.
School, or yeah, maybe they're adults. Yes, so if they're adults, it's okay. But if you're in middle school or you're in high school.
Okay, maybe Brooke is living just downstairs, you know, in the apartment.
Maybe they're neighbors.
Yeah.
For example, these details, I'm a little bit picky. I think about these details when I read a story.
Yeah.
I'm the tough one. I'm the tough critic. I'm thinking, okay, isn't it? Yeah, that's me. So you can think about these details too. Yeah. Think about what I might say. All right. So next, we can say at 1 a.m., Brooke said goodnight and went home.
Okay, so maybe they are for sure adult.
Yeah, maybe. Or they're, I don't know. Let's say they're adults.
Okay.
Because I'm pretty sure if they had parents, their parents would be like, oh, it's already past midnight.
Where are you?
Yeah, it's so late. Okay, so I think they're probably adults, maybe college students. Okay, and then it says Sherry stayed up a bit later using her phone. So that's why we see in the picture that she's playing around with her phone. She's addicted to her smartphone.
Okay, 所以呢，在我们第二部分的这个设定里面呢，我们就看到说，他第一段落继续讲了，他把第一张图和第二张图讲完了。他讲说呢，他们是来这边讨论。那在晚上呢一点的时候，所以呢，注意到我们这个桌子很 很注意这个时钟哦，很注意看这个时间的变化。后来在一点的时候呢 ，Brooke 就是呢离开了他家，那呢他继续熬夜。OK， 他继续熬夜，他没有去睡觉，他继续熬夜，然后开始呢用他的手机了，就看到我们第二张图的这个情境了。
Mm-hmm. All right, so here's actually another great word for you guys to use. You can say browse your phone. So if you're like Sam and I were, before we go to bed, we like to use our phones. You can say, I like to browse my phone in the evening, or I like to surf the internet using my phone. So browsing with your phone is actually good for you to use. So yeah, many of us do this. We spend hours using our phone, looking through Instagram or Facebook. We're not really looking for a specific kind of information. We're not doing research. Yeah. We're just looking around for fun and whatever interests us. So that's why we can say browse the internet. Mm-hmm. When you're looking throughthe internet, when you're looking through maybe Facebook or Instagram, but you don't really have a specific purpose, exactly. You're not looking for anything specific like, I don't know, information.
A recipe.
Yeah, or a recipe, or you're not looking for pictures like, or something.
How to fix your toilet.
How to put on this kind of makeup or something.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's called browsing the internet, when you just are looking for things for fun.
OK, 所以呢我们看到这个句子里面呢他说 browse,OK,、okay, browse 呢就是浏览的意思哦。那他这边他是 browsing Instagram and checking Facebook,OK,、okay, Cherry 呢花时间来看这个Instagram 跟看他的脸书，那注意到呢，我们这个句型啊，这个句子呢，跟大家分析一下，这边是使用了这个分词构句哦。那前面我们是主词加上动词 ，OK，Cherry stayed up for another hour，OK，、okay, 这个是我们前面的这个一个子句。那后逗号后面呢，我们是使用了分词构句哦。OK, 它本来呢应该是要用 and 的形式 OK, 这个应该是它是连贯在一起的，但是呢在这边我们是省略了连接词 and, 然后呢我们直接把第二个动词 browse 变成了这个现在分词 browsing OK, 它不是表示主动的意思 OK, 那如果呢我们是被动的我们可以换成 PP OK, 那我们再看个例句哦 Robert gave a sign of despair OK, knowing that there was no way of winning Jenny back
Oh, so sad
OK, 罗伯特绝望的叹气，心里清楚无法挽回珍妮了。OK, 这个句子呢，其实是前面一个句子 Robert 叹气，后面呢是 Robert 知道他无法挽回珍妮。这两个句子呢，中间其实我们是可以用 and 来连接，但我们这边把 and 省略之后呢，后半的句子变成分词构句，所以 no 变成了 knowing。OK, 这个是我们分词构句的用法。
All right, so that could be the first part of our paragraph. We can move on to the second part. And again, if it's easier for you guys to write a beginning, middle, and the end, then split into three paragraphs, it's fine. But here we have a second paragraph, and we can start off with a second topic sentence like this. 8 hours later, Sherry opened her eyes and glanced at the clock. So, okay, it was 1 a.m., 8 hours later, it's probably around like 9, 10 a.m.
Yep.
So she didn't go back in time. Unfortunately for this story, she did not go back in time. She went forward in time.
No.
The time went normally.
Okay.
So then she opened her eyes and she's like, oh, okay. No.
8 hours later.
Yeah. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. Actually, she slept really, really well then.
Yeah.
She slept a full 8 hours. That's pretty good.
So, yeah, good for her. Okay. 所以看到第二个主题句呢，他说哦，八个小时过去了 ，eight hours later. OK, Sherry opened her eyes, 张开眼睛，然后呢看到这个时钟。OK, 他心里应该是 Oh no. OK, 已经八小时过了。Glance 这个字呢，跟我们这个 look 是一样，也是看，但是呢 ，glance 比较像是瞥眼。OK, 看了一下这个时钟这样子的意思。
Mm-hmm. All right. So she glanced at her clock. So she looked at the clock quickly because maybe she thought, hey, I slept pretty late. How come I slept for a long time? I think we all feel this sometimes when we know we probably overslept. You think to yourself, I think I slept really well and I slept for a long time. So she glanced at the clock and what happened? She'd overslept by 3 hours. So she was supposed to wake up.Maybe like at 7 a.m.、Okay. So she overslept by 3 hours and then she realized she must have forgotten to set her alarm. Oh no.、
Okay.
That really, really, really sucks when that happens because、
yeah.
you're like, But I haven't had that happen to me where I overslept for 3 hours. Like maybe max is like an hour or 30 minutes later because maybe subconsciously I think I have to work. So I know to, I need to wake up at a certain time. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And I don't think I've ever slept that long.
For me, it happened before. Like, yeah, because I always like use my phone before I go to bed. Mm-hmm. And I lay down in bed, like watch videos or like, I don't know, browsing Instagram.
Browsing the internet.
Yeah, and because it's late at night, you fell asleep without setting the alarm clock. You simply fell asleep.
And you forgot everything.
Yeah, you forgot everything. Yeah. And
oh,
it's 8 hours later.
Oh, no.
And you have to take the day off.
I'm sick.
I'm sick. I don't feel so good today.
Yeah, I'm just kidding. Don't do that, guys. I think just try to be honest. If it's possible. If possible, try to be honest. All right, so if that happens, if you wake up and you realize you overslept, we can actually use this phrase. It dawns on somebody that. So it dawns on me that I overslept, or it dawned on Sherry that she overslept. Mm-hmm. So we can actually use this phrase too. So you can say it dawns on somebody that plus a sentence, or you can also change it to the past tense as well. Dawn here is our verb, so we can change it to the past tense. We can say it dawned on somebody that. Okay, so it just depends on what tense you want to use, but dawn here is our verb. For example, I can say it slowly dawned on her that she must have forgotten to set her alarm because she'd been so busy on her phone. Okay, so if we use the same story about Sherry, we can use a sentence like that. Or I can also say, it dawned on Jessica that she left her homework at home. Uh-oh.
Okay, 所以呢，我们看到这个 it dawned on someone, okay, 就是呢，让他渐渐明白，他发现了这件事情，他开始明白这件事情。那在我们句子里面呢，我们是说 it slowly dawned on her, okay, dawned on her, her 这边是那个 Sherry, okay, 他开始渐渐的明白 slowly 是这边渐渐哦 it dawned on her。那呢，我们这边注意到呢，是使用 it 当作虚代词 ，OK， 它代替呢它后面明白的事情 ，OK， 所以呢，我们后面 it dawned on her that OK that 后面呢这个子句呢才是它事实上明白的，才是呢这个真正的主词。但是呢，在前面我们使用 it 呢当作虚主词哦。
And actually, another fun fact about this word is at dawn is when.It's the morning, right? So when the sun comes out. So in some ways, it's kind of like, oh, you're seeing things clearer. You're seeing things more brightly. So that's why we say it dawns on somebody. That is because in the morning time, the sun rises. You kind of see, oh, in the daytime, it looks like this. So we can kind of have the idea of, oh, that's right. This happened. Mm-hmm. All right. So oopsies for Sherry. She forgot to set her alarm clock. So that's why she overslept. Mm-hmm. Okay. We can finish off this sentence or finish off the paragraph with another detail. We can say she checked her phone messages and received some bad news.
Okay.
Oh, so it's not a very happy story. maybe she missed the audition time. So that's why she had to wake up earlier. Or maybe the part she wanted was already chosen. So maybe they already chose someone real quickly. So yeah, it could be something that, you know, a play that you have at school. So these decisions come faster than if you were to work in Hollywood or whatever, where it might take some time.
Yes.
So maybe, oops, she missed the audition time or the part she wanted was already chosen. She can't be the part that she wanted to play anymore.
Yeah, what a waste. Yeah. She was worried about it.
Yeah, don't play with your phone. Right? All right. And then lastly, of course, we need to have a conclusion, which is the end of our story here. So it says, from then on, Sherry resolved to put her goals first and her phone second. So she promised herself that I'm going to focus on doing something first. Achieving my goals first, and then if I really want to use my phone, I'll use it second.
Okay, 这边呢，我们看到 from then on 是从那个时候开始。那如果呢，你是要现在开始下定决心，你可以说 from now on. Okay, 那 the resolve 这个字呢，它就是表示这个下定决心的意思。你当然可以说，比方说 determine to do something 或 decide to do something， 你决定要做这件事情。但 resolve 呢，更有像是比方说像新年新希望啊这种。Okay, 比方说New Year's resolution 这种。你这个新年新愿，你想要立定志向，以后再也不做这样子，我们就可以用 resolve 这个动词。
All right, so let's take a quick break and we'll be right back. Writing sample one. One Saturday evening, Sherry invited her friend Brooke to hang out at her house after seeing a movie together. They stayed up late chatting about Sherry's audition for a local play the next morning at 9 a.m. She was nervous, so she wanted to ask Brooke for some advice about the role she would be trying out for. At 1 a.m., Brooke finally said goodnight and went home. Rather than going straight to bed, however, Sherry stayed up for another hour browsing Instagram and checking Facebook. 8 hours later, Sherry opened her eyes and glanced at the clock. She meant to get up early and rehearse her lines, but she overslept by 3 hours. It slowly dawned on her that she must have forgotten to set her alarm because she'd been so busy on her phone. Dismayed, she picked up her phone and checked her messages. Sure enough, there were 5 missed calls and a text message telling her not to bother going in for the audition. From that point on, Sherry resolved to put her goals first and her phone second. Writing sample 2. On Saturday night, Elizabeth had her friend Julia over for dinner. They hadn't seen each other for some time, so they talked until it was past 10 p.m. Julia had to leave around 10:30 p.m., but they kept chatting on their phones for another couple of hours. After saying goodnight around 1 a.m., Elizabeth continued to use her phone, this time to play games. She also watched a few TV shows. It was past 2 a.m. when Elizabeth finally went to sleep. The next morning, Elizabeth woke up at 10 a.m. Suddenly, she remembered that she was supposed to meet some friends for brunch at 10:30 a.m. She got ready as fast as she could, but she was still very late to the restaurant. Her friends forgave her, and they still had a nice brunch. But Elizabeth was ashamed. She felt she disrespected her friends by forgetting about the plans they made. She promised herself that she wouldn't be so forgetful in the future or stay up so late if she had a morning appointment. Yep, unfortunately for Sherry, she didn't really get the part and she overslept.
Yeah.
So yeah, maybe she should talk to people. She should have a cutoff time for when you talk to people at night.
Yes, he should like plan everything out and follow the schedule.
Because to be honest, like for me, I also don't like talking to people too late at night because at a certain time, I want to get ready for bed. So if people talk to me during the time I want to get ready for bed, they delay me. So I get kind of annoyed, so I'm like, oh, I don't answer my phone after blah, blah, blah. It's horrible, but I need my beauty sleep. I'm sorry. All right, so that's the end of our article for today.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, you can have fun with the story. You can be silly. You can make it as fun as you want. You can include a twist in the story.
Mm-hmm.
But just remember these key points, and hopefully this will help you if you are writing a picture writing story in the future.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so we'll see you guys next time.
Bye.